Hello, welcome to 9design 3D. Today, I will show you how to create your own hair textures maps in the Blender. There is another method, you can make it in the Photoshop with a different hair type brush, but I will show all of things in the Blender with the particle system hair. Let's go to the tutorial. First, we will set up our camera angle. With the Alt-R, you can reset your camera rotation as a zero. And after that, under the output settings, you can set up your resolution X and Y in 4K or 2K. Our render engine will be cycles, and under the film, don't forget to check your transparent. If you want, you can set up your viewport overlays and hide your fuller and axis. Now we will add a plane to our scene. Under the particle with the plus icon, you can set up your new particle system as an hair. Don't forget to check advanced. You can rotate your plane in the y-axis 19. Under the particle settings, you can set up your number, seed, hair length and segments. Which shape or which type you want hair, you can set it up in here because we will add some color on it. Under the physics and forces, set your Brownian like the untidy look. Under the children, don't forget to change it interpolated and displayed amount and render amount will be 10. And under fit, under the curve, you can set up your curve type as a wave, curve or how you want. And with this amplitude, clump and shape, frequency, values, set and change your hair type's look. You can set something on, maybe some box braid. We will make different type of the hair shapes. Under the hair shapes, you can set your diameter root and diameter scale. But before all of this, we have to change our point light's location for giving some light to our hairs. With the scaling your plane of the hair particle system, set it and place near of your angle. You can set your roughness threshold or change your curve method as a braid. When you make it braid, you can set your own long braid hair type. Maybe if you want, you can set it in here. But I will change it a bit untidy look and different fluffy shape. Go to materials and set new hair material to yourself. I will make it a bit pink and red color on my hair. If you want, you can set it up yellow, blue, which color you want. With the decreasing your roughness a bit and increasing your specular, set your materials values like this. After you're okay, you can shift it to duplicate your hair particle system from here. And under the particle, press new particle settings button. After that, when you change something on your second particle system, it will not affect your first hair particle system. And now, for your second particle, you can set it up your number, seed, hair length, segments with the different type and shape. With the changing your volume or forces as a Brownian, with the untidy look as I said before, you can use this type of things. Under the curve, I will change it to the curl. And with the amplitude and clump, you can give some wave onto your hair. Again with the Shift D, I will make different type of it as a maybe spiral or wave. Change your amplitude and give dense wave for your this hair particle with the shape. For this hair, you can go from the top left and set it to the particle edit. Under a fit, with the hair comb, you can tidy your hairs, or with the cut tool, you can cut your hairs. With the giving some fluffy, you can choose your fluff tool and give some shape of your particle hair system. As you see, I'm making some difference on it and I like this look with the changing little extra things. You can set your point light again and shift it to duplicate it. We will make some baby hair type little hair particle. Settings in here too. You can delete this edit on it. For the second, it will not affect others. As we made before, for this, you can change your curl type and other species from here. Again, when you want, you can set it up with the particle edit your hair shape. After you set your baby hair parts, you can shift it to duplicate it again. After the scaling, give some other and different species for the making your character's hair different from the others. Again, we will shift it to duplicate it and press new particle system button again. Give a different shape for the little hairs. After all the things done and set up your point light's power, you can go from the render and press render image. After you rendered your image, we will use this in a different program, but it's totally free. Don't forget to save as this is with the file format PNG and color RGBA. From the bounding box software sites, you can download this materialized program from here to your computer. After you download it, in the folder you will find this .exe file. You can double click on it. Preview will be look like this. Under the diffuse map, with the pressing O as mean the open, choose your hair PNG. After you set it up, it will look like this. Under the height map, you can press create button. As you see, it will affect it like this. With the frequency weight equalizer, you can decrease your other values and give some final contrast and final gain for your height map. When you like it, you can press set as height map and it will become in here. For the normal map, I will use this randomly. With the default settings, you can press create and set as normal map. It's not necessary, but if you want, you can get some ambient occlusion map from here too. I won't use it in the Blender, but I wanted to show it in here. After all the things done, choose your file format PNG and near them, under the height map, choose S button for the save. Give a name of your PNG files. Save them to your texture folder. After all the things done in here, our maps will be came in here like this. We will use them now. Add a plane to your Blender file, scale and place it. With the adding new material here to create, add an image texture with the Shift A, connect your color to principal color alpha to principal BSDF alpha. After that, open your main hair texture. Under the viewport settings, you can change your blend mode to the alpha hashed. And now, in the cycles, it will look like this. You can add another point light in here. See your hair textures clearly. It will look like this. And with the pressing Ctrl T, you can add some mapping node in here. In tab to edit mode, select all U and unwrap. Under the UV editing tab, you can set your UV maps to fit up your hair texture. In the scaling with the UV editing part, you can rotate it and set up your hair UV editing map onto your plane. After you reset all the things, it will look like this. Now, we will add an image texture again, and we will add some normal map node. Connect them together and connect normal to normal. With the mapping nodes vector connected to, and choose your normal map, and it will affect like this. Let's look others. You can shift it to duplicate this plane. If you want, you can press new material button for the making maybe new color with the color ramp. I will only show how to place your plane in the UV editing map. With the changing your UV editings and texture, your hair cards will look like this. When you want, which shape you want, you can make it and use it onto your game ready characters. And these hair cards will be game ready. I showed before how to make some different type of hair textures. We downloaded something from the Gumroad. You can go from the top right card and check how to use and how to place your hair cards to your character's head. I will make new videos about it. And now, thank you for watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. See you later in new tutorials.